Kuyo, you had a point, but people were tied at two. It didn't matter. Five people were at 2 points. We're trying to get one of them at three. All right, here we go, y'all. Let's go play hardcore anti-rim. What did I just say? Hardcore anti-Aaron? I don't know what I just said. Hardcore anti-Aaron. All right, hardcore uprising. Anti-Aaron is back here. Y'all stop being nasty. This is a family-friendly guessing game. This is not some HBO 3 at 2 a.m. It's too early in the morning to be nasty anyway. Good lord, you need to get some. Now you go to a Bible study or to just cleanse the mind of the nastinesses. Just nasty. All right, y'all. Countdown's going for Aaron, and here we go. Lord, have mercy. My poor chat. Ugh, y'all just so nasty.
Rising mode with the ever overpowered DLC Sayuri. And they say don't bring a gun to a knife fight, I bring a knife to a gunfight. So, let's get everything set up. And another one of Konami's wonderful classic games. And in 3, 2, 1, go. We're going with the XBO because the load times between stages are quicker. I have 9 lives instead of 30. Don't ask me why, but with this, we have auto fire, full health, max speed, max everything. It's pretty much considered a new game plus in a way. She just cuts right through everything. Like a hot knife through butter. We know it's Konami, we have it's Contra, we have a wall boss. So we just cut right through. Original Contra players can recognize that climb. So what we do is we just stay in here and dash a lot. Dash and cut. Use your action to hop over the turrets. Fire beams. And we go biking. Yeah, it's just like Strider. But between the gun and the blade, this mode is faster. And if she takes a hit and falls down, she doesn't lose any of her quick kills. The only way she could ever lose a quick kill is if she falls into a pit. So what we try to do is not fall into any pits unless we have to. And I need to lean back, because I forgot. So we step up and we chop her down. I guess he doesn't know when to quit. So we hold our strife in and back. Take down that half. Take down that with no problems. hardest trick of the game. Landing that jump. Okay, someone's having fun with the camera. 301 for the stage, which is not that bad. So yeah, another game that I speedrun that actually runs on the in-game clock. The jungle, where we have poison plants, snipers, and a whole bunch of everything that's out to kill you. And another wall boss. Although it is a bit more difficult, but we don't need to worry about that, because we just cut right through it. Oh, I can't wait to go back and actually see what you're doing with my camera. If you're wanting to upgrade, this is where you get the... Wow. How do I fail that? Should I be worried about that, man? I'd be worried about what's going on with the live stream right now. Such a strange film.
True warrior. Mission. It's done. stupendous.
Discover the radio.
true warrior.
So basically, as you can see, she is definitely overpowered. It is like freaking Strider, and I don't think whatever happened during stage two there, I was watching and that kind of completely threw me off. That's kind of why I turned off the mic. But yeah, this is the lab, and as you saw, I fell into the fire, which means that I fell into a pit, which means I lost my quick kill for the boss. But that's alright, it happens. But till then, you know, she mows the lawn of all the DLC characters in the game. She is definitely worth it, because anybody can, play with this character, you know, and as soon as you get the basic, the mechanics of how she goes through all the stages, and on when you decide to try any characters who have a gun, you are pretty much well prepared. So here we are at the start of the Alien Wars, because here is the alien. And what most people don't realize is that in the Contra series, this is a prequel to the original Contra series. And if you ever played, and this is also the people who created the Guilty Gear. This was Mega Man X, I'd be using Start as my jump. Autopilot, yeah. Thankfully, where everything that could go wrong has gone wrong, at least in this game. If it happened in Act Zero, it would have been worse. Scrolling trains. Best thing about these stages is that they're all the same. Once you figure out the patterns and everything like that, you have nothing to worry about. Now, if you were a regular character, you'd be like this, dodging the fires and the flames. Me, I like to be a dragon force and go through the fire and the flames, because she's got the bubble jump or ninja jump, so impervious is always nice. On rising mode. So we take care of these guys that fall down, the same thing, which is always the same pattern. Then we have the eyeball, the Igor. These two fun buddies. Come here. Be a little fancy. But regardless, this is a bad run, but you know, the show must go on, because apparently I'm live in Technicolor. Yeah, that worked out well. You are the world record holder of this category, and you're acting like a novice. She definitely, yeah. And we got one more. Let's not fall off the train this time. So, I went from playing with 9 lives to 4. Usually, I still have all my lives. Plus, it's one of those days. Can we do this in one cycle? One cycle cut. Alright, at least we didn't fall down. But we still make good use of it. No, we're not in the underwater aquarium. But we were before, because I was doing some Tetris Splash. So that was the underwater aquarium that you could have seen. Yep. This is the start of it all. The start of the entire Contra series, Alien Wars, Super C, original Contra. How it all begins again. And we have the wonderful stairs we would climb and just slash through. As we climb the tower, with only 4 lives and 4 death skips, we need to take. So, yeah. So, I need to be very careful when I'm doing helicopter skip. And I need to be very careful. All the rest. So, as we climb the elevators, having our Turtles in Time moment, or was there any other Contra game that had elevators? I did not need to take. So one copter skip. Dealt with. So I guess I have no choice. Yep, this is by far one of the worst runs I've ever had during a showcase. I will say that. Easiest runs I do very poorly. One of the most difficult runs. I make it look like a cakewalk.
Did you show up just to be killed?
Yeah, arcade mode is impossibly hard. Rising, it's kind of like an easy mode. Now, always make sure that you move there because the floor, it does collapse. Oh, you can earn lives. No. Normally, I am really on point where I don't need to use all 30 lives. But due to, I guess, this run not being up to par or technical difficulties when looking at my computers to read chat, kind of threw everything off.
Time to say goodbye.
I won't let you escape.
Banzai kick. But yeah, she really does make a quick work.
A true warrior.
30. Even with how bad I'm doing, I'm still exiting the tower at 30. I don't get it. And now the final stage. Six rockets. Run back. Run back. Run back. Six more rockets. If we can get the air dash. Yeah, the last boss that has the best one end. Yeah, she cuts right through the entire song. It's like, won't get a chance to enjoy it. Through gauntlet very nicely. I'm not gonna death warp here, so no electric slide. Take another one right there if I wanted to warp up right here. Oh, this this boss is very difficult. Because of these eyeballs here, and the fact that you could fall off the platform and watch everything go to crap. So I'll just be very cautious. And take my time. Get on the ceiling where you can make short work of all these. Wait till it goes somewhere around you and then get out, no problem. And now the final boss. That easy. Like most of these games, you know, when it's designed to be a speedrun, they make sure that that people have the ability to go fast. And we take them down like so. Save it. If you're with a gun and you need a laser, there it is. What's our final in-game time? Let's find out. And our final in-game time is 36:46. Not bad.
A true warrior.
Not bad at all. And that was Hardcore's Uprising series. Thank you all. Have a good day, and I'm going to enjoy my birthday.